honey chim chim, cherry chim cherry.
To make me late. Where's my hat?
Thank you.
and never to stir. Well educated, yet willing to learn. I'm clean and honest, my manner refined. And I wear shoes of the sensible kind. I suffer no nonsense, and whilst I remain, there's nothing else I feel I need explain. I'm practically perfect. Thank you.
Nearly there.
Things don't count. You make them up.
And where do you think words came from in the first place? Someone had to make them up.
Now, I suppose we could use each letter more than once. Super. Caliph. Fragilistic. Expialidocious.
Of course it's a word. And unless I'm very much mistaken, I think it's going to be rather useful.
When trying to express oneself, it's frankly quite absurd to leaf through lengthy lexicons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation keen. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. If you hear the sound of it, it's something quite atrocious. If you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Thank you.
so I refused some German chap a loan. It seems he went to our chief rival. They gave him the money, and now it's turned into a gold mine.
Well, they can't expect you to get it right every time.
Can they? That's exactly what they expect. That is more than loud enough. Go to your room. I don't care what you were just upstairs now. Where's my briefcase? I put it here. Michael? Jane? Will you give it to me? Must I put up with this kind of behavior? You're their mother. Why can't you do something?
Well, I can try not shouting for a start.
Mary Poppins, you are here to teach the children manners. And just look at them. They're a pair of little savages. If I had my way, you'd be out of here.
You're tired.
Mary Poppins, would you take the children upstairs, please? Mr. Banks is quite exhausted. Perhaps you keep them occupied. I hope you haven't forgotten that. Tonight's my evening out.
What?
Oh dear, I have quite forgot. I suppose the best people would ask you to change your plans.
No, ma'am, they wouldn't.
Mary Poppins, take the children upstairs, please.
George?
What is it now?
I thought you might like to talk about it.
What would be the point?
Perhaps I can help.
Don't be ridiculous.
George, I'm being serious. If you have troubles, I'd like you to share them.
Don't worry, you will. The fact is, I've been suspended without salary until they decide what to do with me.
Sometimes families are upside down. For a while, anyway.
Mr. Von Hustle because his scheme was hollow. It had no product, it had no substance, it had no meaning outside the walls of a bank. Oh yes, he talked to me about assets and profits and growth, but there wasn't a word about people. I know that if a man puts any value on real life, then as far as you're concerned, he's a washout, but I'm afraid I do value it. In short, George Banks Esquire has rediscovered the human race. I apologize for ruining the bank, but I do not apologize for understanding that there are more important things in life than making money.
Ruining the bank, ruining the bank, ruining the bank. My dear chap, what are you talking about? You've saved our bacon. Von Hustler's scheme has ruined our rival. You've kept us out of the nastiest scandal since records began. We don't want your apology. We're offering ours.
Oh, my word.
And another thing, you're better giving a loan to a fellow called Northbrook, who's repaying it opening two new factories. With the percentage you negotiated, we look set to make a fortune.
Oh, my word.
That's just it. We very much hope you may tell us that you did. Just give us the word. Quite safe with us.
Give you the word? Give you the word, I'll give you the word, all right. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious!
Mind if you do. No, I loved it, but there's a role I'd much rather play.